ബന്ധനം ഉർവാരുക്മിവ ബന്ധനം മൃത്യോർമുക്ഷിയമാമൃതാത്.
The first talk is by Dr. Irene Caesar. Her title is Remote Management of Biosystems via the Digitized Biohologram of the Human Embryonic Stem Cell based on the wave optics of chromosomes for focusing genetic information. And she's the CEO of Matrix City LLC in Russia and president of Wave Genome LLC in the US.
Hello everybody. We are right now at the turning point in the development of human civilization. GMO producing countries entered the stage of genetic collapse. The alternative to the genetic collapse is the quantum leap part in biology via laser biohologography. Either biology makes quantum leap or human civilization will get destroyed. According to the Russian biologist Dr. Irina Ermakova, if a female rat is fed with GMO soy, her third generation offspring becomes sterile. If both a female and a male rats are fed with GMO soy, their second generation offspring becomes sterile. Thus, the genetically modified organisms are the weapons in the binary biological warfare, which would result in total and complete sterilization of world population. GMO constitutes up to 80% of the US food supply. Even more, all GMO producing countries like Great Britain, Germany, United States, Canada, Australia, France are the contaminated zones where harmful genetic material is spread via groundwater, pollen, agricultural animal manure, and insects. Transgenic contamination means that even people who eat organic will be sterilized and will not be able to have children in the second generation. So instead of overpopulation, we get a problem of human extinction. In parallel, we see George Church of Harvard and Jennifer Doudna of Berkeley starting their race to patent a synthetic embryo. Monsanto is named as a major beneficiary of the synthetic embryo. The plan is clear. Monsanto made seeds sterile on purpose so that farmers would not be able to grow their own seeds, and Monsanto will sell seeds as the right to survive. Now we see the same plan for the human babies. If Monsanto wins, humans will buy from Monsanto the right to have a child. George Church and Jennifer Doudna promise us that the synthetic embryo will exceed the regular human in beauty and ability, both physical and mental. The synthetic embryo is planned to become a genetically modified human via the protocol of RNA interference. In 1998, Philip Sharp's graduate student at MIT, Andrew Fire, had created with Craig Mellow the binary biological weapon through RNA interference, Nobel Prize 2006. They found out that if C. elegans worm is fed with its own genetic material, the worm dies. Especially effective is the short double-stranded RNA given to the worm. This is to explain why the Americans bought Russian RNA in 2017. Likewise, this is to the question of why all the Satanists who drink human blood exhibit such mental deterioration, and why the Jews who consume dry human blood in matzah as the part of their religious ritual have so many genetic diseases, and why Peter Thiel, the member of the steering committee of the Bilderberg Club, who injects himself with human blood of a teenager, is doomed for degeneration. The carcinogenic nature of high-protein diet is also explained by the danger of the RNA interference. Humans need to consume food that is removed from their own genome as far as possible. The danger of RNA interference also explains why the food diet of the Cro-Magnon men cooked on fire had preserved in them the high intellect of their megalithic titanic ancestors. We need to once and forever understand that the project of the synthetic embryo via the RNA interference with its adding to human embryo the human genetic material will not work. Synthetic embryo will not solve the problem of the looming human extinction. The approaching genetic collapse makes the agenda of the quantum leap in biology via the bioholography urgent. We need to reject all the pre-quantum leap technologies like BCI, brain-computer interface, brain chipping, nanobots, and CRISPR-Cas9 as technologies that are based upon the flawed science and bring humanity to its last hour. Quantum leap in biology is based upon the application of quantum physics to biology. Quantum non-locality in relation to biology is the biological quantum non-locality. For the purpose of stopping genetic collapse, the biological quantum non-locality allows us the remote management of biosystems via the digitized biohologram of the human embryonic cell based upon the wave optics of chromosomes for focusing genetic information. The same gene gets expressed in dysfunctional individuals via acrocentric chromosome and in functional individuals by metacentric chromosome. Here we see on the left acrocentric, on the right metacentric chromosome. The chromosome consists of two chromatids combined together in the X form. The two chromatids intersect in the center where they exchange their genetic material. Metacentric chromosomes are the X-shaped chromosomes with two arms that are equal in length. Acrocentric chromosomes are chromosomes with two arms that are not equal in length, meaning they exhibit growth asymmetry. The acrocentric chromosome has the center which is not symmetrically removed for the same distance from the two ends of the chromatids. Since universe is a hologram, I argue that our chromosome and the entire genetic apparatus function analogously to our eyes, according to the laws of wave optics in the holograms. The shape of chromosomes is so crucial since the improper geometrical shape of the chromosome literally cannot get the focus or the zero center in the hologram. Zero center, the quantum physics term. Our chromosomes function via the geometrical codes of refraction in the liquid crystal media. Metacentric chromosome is analogous to a well-centered and focused eye crystal, while acrocentric chromosome is analogous to a myopic or farsighted eye. A myopic or a farsighted eye gets the focus of the retina and so cannot properly function. The hologram of a chromosome out of focus results in the malfunction of the entire organism. Chromosome is a lens that allows our cells to focus the needed wave information during cell division, analogously to a crystal of our eye. The Przewalski horse and the domesticated horse have absolutely identical DNA from the biochemical point of view. And the only difference between the Przewalski horse and the domesticated horse is that their homologous genes that have the same function, have chromosomes which have different geometrical structure in the wild horse and the domesticated horse. The wild horse has acrocentric chromosomes and the domesticated horse has metacentric chromosomes, different in shape from acrocentric chromosomes. Apes differ from humans in the same way as wild horses differ from domesticated horses. Genes in apes that are homologous to specific human genes differ from human genes only by the structure of their chromosomes. Human chromosomes are metacentric, while the homologous genes in apes have acrocentric chromosomes. The same is true of humans with Down syndrome. Children with Down syndrome have extra acrocentric chromosomes. Children with Down syndrome differ from normal children by the failure in the optical geometry of their chromosomes. These are the proofs that the geometrical optics in chromosomes and bioholography in general is the universal law in biology across the species. Evidently, the acrocentric chromosome is the result of the destruction of the metacentric chromosome, literally, it's splitting into halves. Analogously, male chromosome, which is acrocentric, is the result of degeneration of female chromosome, which is properly metacentric. Here we see male dysfunctional and female functional chromosomes. Analogously, the shortening of the telomeres is crucial for genome, only because it leads to the destruction of the proper geometrical shape of chromosomes. Human enhancement is possible only through mastering the wave optics of chromosomes by bioholography. Current genetic engineering by RNA interference, CRISPR-Cas9, destroys the wave optics of chromosomes, that is the refraction codes in bioholograms. Major failure of CRISPR-Cas9 is not simply the off-site base pairing, which makes CRISPR-Cas9 not precise at all. Major failure of CRISPR-Cas9 is the promotion of the numerical and structural abnormalities in chromosomes. Chromosomal aberrations have been linked to cancer and inherited genetic disorders, and the chromosomes of many tumor cells exhibit irregular bands. Structural abnormalities are duplication, deletion, translocation, and inversion. All these characterize CRISPR-Cas9 genetic engineering. Thus, cancer cure lies not with CRISPR-Cas9 protocol, but vice versa, in the complete abandonment of CRISPR-Cas9 and other genetic modifications based upon cutting and pasting of DNA snippets. To cope with the structural abnormalities in chromosomes introduced by CRISPR-Cas9, we need to go to the source, to the human embryonic stem cell, which is not touched by any genetic engineering. We need to outlaw CRISPR-Cas9, GMO, and any other forms of RNA interference. Our goal should be the recording of the intact bioholograms of the human embryonic cells untouched by genetic engineering. In this way, we can stop the killing of human embryos, that is the cannibalism under the name of CRISPR-Cas9. In April 2018, President Vladimir Putin has confirmed that Russia will develop along the path of the nature-like technologies. Nature-like technologies preserve the organic wholesomeness of bioholograms. The enhancement of the biohologram is possible only by the strengthening of its organic wholesomeness and more precision of the zero center focus in the wave optics of chromosomes. Genome is holographic. Since universe is holographic, we can record and transmit only holographic information based upon changing the refraction of the scalar wave diffraction grating in chromosomes. Genome is a hologram with its structural geometrical code. World is 93% energy and only 7% particles, which are concentrated energy. This energy exists in non-local and unique holograms. 7% of particles correspond to 2% of desired DNA. 98% of DNA is not a junk DNA, but the specific configurations of the refraction codes of the geometrical optics of genome. According to holographic principle, universe is entirely in its every matrix point. The implication of the holographic principle, which I formulated in 2012, states that if universe is entirely in its every matrix point, then every matrix point is not simply different from any other matrix point, but is unique. This means that every wave matrix is both non-local and unique. Thus, if we have two exact copies of the same non-local wave matrix, we can transmit information instantaneously and remotely from one copy of the same non-local unique wave matrix to the other copy. Therefore, the precision in the biomedical engineering is achieved not via the precision of localization, but vice versa, via the precision of refraction in the unique and non-local bioholograms, aka wave crystals. In the 1980s, I formulated a hypothesis that holograms function as refractive crystalline wave structures, aka wave crystals, which fold the signal via reflecting this signal upon itself due to polarization. Thus, the holographic signal is a folded signal. The process of folding creates refraction and focus. In 2014, I extended my 1980s wave crystal theory to the geometrical optics and chromosomes. I argue that the structure of the hologram is the structure of refraction in the scalar wave diffraction grating. Scalar wave emerges because the external signal gets reflected upon itself due to the polarization in the hologram. Polarization emerges due to the change in the spin of in the integral torsion of the DNA. The secret in the remote biomedical engineering as quantum biocomputing lies in the recording and instantaneous transmission of a structural phantom geometrical code of refraction. I will introduce the new method of recording and remote transmitting of biohograms via laser spectroscopy encoding electrodes on nano-level via laser. The technology creates lenses assisting our chromosomes in correcting their refraction for focusing genetic biohologographic information both locally and remotely. The same way we use lenses to correct eyesight, we can use artificial lenses to correct geometrical optics and chromosomes. My companies, Matrix City and Wave Genome, were pioneers in creating, conducting clinical trials and making a commercial offer of such lenses as electrode-based chips coded via laser nano-level with the digitized bioholograms of healthy organs and physiological systems, the digitized bioholograms of healthy children, and the digitized bioholograms of pharmaceuticals. I was the first scientist in the world who offered to create the digitized bioholograms of pharmaceutical drugs via laser spectrography and the digitized bioholograms of healthy bodily organs and physiological systems as a comprehensive digital holographic pharmacy. I was the first scientist in the world who have succeeded in proving in clinical trials that the chip encoded by the digitized hologram of the pharmaceutical drug on nano level by laser and the digital pharmacy of e-holograms function better than the conventional pharmaceutical drug, more effectively, with no overdose and no side effects. And I was the first scientist in the world who commercially offered the remote laser treatment via the prototype of laser polarized biohologography as quantum holographic bi-internet or holonet in 2013, prior to everybody else in the field. Wave Genome preceded Google's bioelectronic drugs R&D program for 6 years of actual global sales and 50 years beyond R&D. My companies were the first to make a commercial offer of the chip for the protection from psychotronic and genetic warfare. When your cells divide, the biohologram on the chip makes your chromosome center in focus, since chromosomes send and receive information holographic signal via the zero center of their wave crystals in accordance with their shape, similar to how our eye functions. Changing focus depending on the shape of eye crystal refraction via diffraction grating. In October-December 2013, I have conducted clinical trials for two chips of electrode nature structured on nano-level via laser with the digitized biohologram of aspirin and the digitized biohologram of the human embryonic stem cell. Scientific groups headed by me consisted of scientists from the Moscow Bauman State Science University, the largest and most important science university in Russia of MIT level. We used a newly invented Russian laser spectrograph. A mathematical model to digitize the bioholograms was created by the same scientists who created the mathematical model for the new Russian top rocket Kalibr. The clinical trials were headed by Professor Alexander Volkov, the head of the Research Educational and Medical Center of the Moscow Bauman Science University. This new research and development offers a new level of precision and verification of polarized holography for the bioelectronic drugs and bi-internet, which are commercially offered by my companies. The clinical trials were blind experiments and corresponded to all government laws and regulations. And results clearly demonstrated that in comparison with placebo, the new chip invented by my company causes the body reaction similar to taking an aspirin pill and the radical improvement of well-being in the case of the chip coated with a digitized biohologram of the human embryonic stem cell. Here is the drawing. These successful verification experiments have proven my theory of genetics as wave optics of biohologography. Hologram was created by the holographic signal. Holographic signal is defined by polarization in the integral torsion of DNA and chromosome. Reflection of the lineal external signal upon themselves due to polarization so that the diffraction grating of the scale extending zero wave emerges. Diffraction of the further signals towards the zero center of focus of the emerging hologram aka wave crystal due to the scalar wave diffraction grating. So polarization, according to holographic principle, universe is entirely in its every matrix point. This means that every biohologram has opposite poles, each pole being the change of the spin in the integral torsion. Reflection, the change of the spin causes each linear external signal to reflect upon itself inside the hologram so that the scalar standing wave emerges when the peak of the forward going wave is nullified by the trough of the same wave when it is reflected upon itself. When diffraction grating emerges, the signal not only gets refracted towards the zero center of the hologram, but also its frequency changes. That is, the initial signal gets scaled in the phases of the scalar wave. The scalar wave diffraction grating refracts the external linear signal towards the zero center of the wave crystal hologram analogously to the focus of the crystal in our eye. By changing the shape of the crystal, the refraction within the diffraction grating, our eye receives different information, and so do our chromosomes. Interference of diffraction grating of the scalar wave possesses coherence for the further refraction of the following external signals toward the zero center of the wave crystal. Thank you.
Trambakam yajamahe sugandhim pushti vardhanam.